Coronavirus, the name you may have heard unsurprisingly in the news these days, is a family of viruses that can cause diseases as mild as common cold to severe diseases like SARS, severe acute respiratory syndrome. The 2019 coronavirus, also commonly known as the Wuhan's coronavirus due to its origin in the city of Wuhan in China, is named by WHO, the World Health Organization, as the Sars Cov 2, severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus 2, causing the disease COVID-19, coronavirus disease of 2019. The virus is similar in structure to the Sars Cov virus, which caused an outbreak of severe acute respiratory syndrome between 2002 and 2003. Bats serve as the main host reservoir for the SARS-related coronavirus. SARS-CoV-2 is thought to have cross-species jump, where the virus gets transferred from one species into another. Some Chinese researcher has also found out that there is only one amino acid difference between the viruses found in pangolins, a scaly anteater, and those found in humans, suggesting it to be the intermediate host. Pangolins are traded all over the world, as their scales are thought to be useful for protection and are used in some spiritual rituals. The spread of virus from one person to another is similar like a flu virus. Primarily, we have respiratory droplets when a person coughs or sneezes within 6 feet or 1.8 meter range, or indirectly touching the contaminated object with hands and then touching the mucosal surfaces of eyes and nose. The person that catches the virus is said to be infected, but the infected person usually do not show any symptoms and is called asymptomatic. The incubation period, the time starting from when the person gets the virus until he develops any symptoms like fever, cough, shortness of breath, is usually 2 to 14 days. This period can vary between person to person and can also vary between person with different health conditions. The complications include pneumonia, multi-organ failure in which multiple organs of the body are affected, and ARDS, acute respiratory distress syndrome. Now, let's look at the structure and entry of the virus in a human cell. The structure of the virus is not much complicated. It just consists of the genetic material surrounded by viral proteins. In the case of SARS-CoV-2, the genome of the virus consists of single-stranded RNA, unlike the double-stranded DNA found in our cells. Viruses don't contain any cellular machinery, so in order to replicate, meaning to increase their number, they have to hijack the host cell. In case of our SARS-CoV-2 virus, it contains these sticky proteins on the outside called the spike membrane and the envelope proteins, which make up the viral envelope covering its genome. These proteins stick on our respiratory surfaces and let the entry of the virus in our lungs. The virus has sufficient affinity for the receptor found in human cells called the angiotensin converting enzyme 2 or ACE2, which they use to gain entry into the human cell. Since these receptors are found abundantly in the alveolar cells of the lung, so this virus affects the lungs the most. The RNA of the virus is positive sense, meaning it can act as messenger RNA. In our cells, DNA is copied in the form of messenger RNA. The messenger RNA goes out of the nucleus to the nuclear pores and get translated in the form of proteins. The viral protein get assembled to form these tiny baby viruses, which then hijack other host cells. The diagnosis of COVID-19 is being done by standard testing set by WHO, the real-time reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction, RT-RT-PCR. This test is done on respiratory samples taken through various methods. Results are often available in few hours, or it may take as long as 2 days. Another method for diagnosis is a CT scan, which has a characteristic finding called a ground glass opacity. No vaccines or specific antiviral treatments are available, so the treatment is done using supportive care, providing fluids, oxygen, and ventilator support for patients having severe breathing problems. So the goal of every person in the world is to reduce the epidemic peak or flattening the epidemic curve. So what we can do to reduce this outbreak is stay home, avoid travels, wash hand with soap, and practice good hygiene. And stay alert with the number of cases and the spread of the virus, but not anxious, as a healthy mind makes a healthy body.